Yes, this is David Maiman demonstrating his wild side and wowing over 2.5 million people with this. The only fully functional jetpack in the world.
I need to get a jetpack ASAP.
Yeah, sorry, Hakeem. There's only one of these bad boys. We jetted off to California to meet chief designer Nelson Tyler and pilot David Maiman to find out what drove them to build the beast of all creations.
I was 10 years old, and on the radio was Buck Rogers, and he came out of a spaceship, put on his jetpack, and I figured I've got to have one of those.
I've always wanted to fly, you know, myself, so I got into skydiving to do that. That's a little dangerous, I thought, so hey, let's take up something safe like jetpack flying. I mean, the jetpack is, it's science fiction to a lot of people, but it is, it's true. It's here. It's sitting right there.
But how do they get their jetpack off the ground?
We've seen jetpacks before, but this one is special. This one can achieve a vertical takeoff and can fly thousands of feet in the air.
The JB9 is made using a carbon fiber corset, which is strong enough to take the weight of the engine, but light enough to be worn.
The turbine engines in this jetpack work the same way as the jet engine in an aircraft, and the explosive force of the exhaust coming out of the back of the jetpack sends the wearer in the opposite direction, up.
As the fuel burns off, David's rig gets lighter, which means he can go faster, up to speeds of 100 kilometers an hour or 60 miles an hour.
It's funny, when people have seen me fly on video, they go, that's interesting. When they come out and they feel the vibration and the noise and they see me take off and like disappear, it's like, oh wow.
But how does David maneuver this magnificent machine?
David controls the jetpack using two handheld levers. On the right is throttle, and on the left is a twist grip for direction.
It moves two fins, which are under the jet engines. They're called yaw wings, and by deflecting the exhaust gases in different directions, it pushes David different ways.
By controlling the orientation of these two fins, David can perform some impressive tricks in the air. If he directs the output of one forward and the other backwards, he'll spin in place like a top.
But to go side to side, he just has to reposition his body and adjust his weight to induce a turn.
David can also push forward on both levers. This physically moves the angle of the engines, tilting them forward and making it easier for David to move in that direction.
To be the jetpack guy, A, it was the technical challenge of achieving this when nobody else had, and B, it's a hell of a lot of fun to do. I mean, honestly, it's a blast.
It's finally happened, you know? It's here it is. Hey, everybody, come get your jetpack. It's not something that only a superhuman could fly.
For us, this is the future of personal transport.
Jetpacks have always been the stuff of dreams, but now they are a reality, and it looks better than I ever imagined.